Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video we are going to learn how to add routers in EVENG, which is a network simulator tool which you can use to perform labs, and it's an amazing tool. So let's start. First we will open VMware and start our EVENG virtual machine. So I'm starting this. To perform this you need a third party software also, which can be either FileZilla or WinSCP. You can use any of these, both are simple and fine. I'll provide both of the download links of the softwares in the description. So as you can see, my EVNG has been opened and here is my IP. So I will use the tool FileZilla. Let me open FileZilla. It looks like this. So for transferring router images, you need to download the router and images. So for that, I have provided the link in the description for the router's images. Like, let me open my browser. Here you can see it's the FileZilla download link and this is the WinSCP download link. Now, this is my iOS router download link. So you have to download these both two files. So one is of 3700 series and the another router is of 7200 series. So you need to right click, then download the second image and right click and then download. So as you can see, both files have started downloading. So as you can see, my both of the files have been downloaded. Now you need to go in the FileZilla again, and here in the first box, which is for host, here you need to type the IP of your EVNG, which is in my case 172.16.126.129. So I'll type here 172.16.126.129, and the username by default is root and the password is EVE, and the port number which we are gonna use is 22, which is SFTP. So after that, click quick connect, then just click OK, then press OK. So as you can see, I have accessed the EVNG remotely on FileZilla. On the right side there is EVNG files and on the left side I have my desktop files. So I need to transfer the iOS images of routers to EVNG. So first, here you can see two dots, just double click on that. And here you can see all the folders. Here you need to go to the option OPT. Just double click, and after reaching here, click on Unit Lab. After this, go to Add-ons. Then here, go to the first folder, which is Dynamics. So here it is empty right now. Here, from my desktop, I will transfer the iOS router images here. So here is my PC files. So I have kept the downloaded images in my downloads folder. Just double click, and here you can see both of my images. So I have selected both of them together. Just right click and click on upload. So as you can see, both the files have been transferred successfully. To grant the permission for usage in EVNG, so for that we will select these both of them, then right click and click on file permissions. So I'll make the value 777, which makes all the permissions possible. Now click on OK, and this process has been completed. Now just close the FileZilla and now open the EVNG. Here login with root as username and EVE. So as you can see, my EVE has been opened. Now you need to type a command here, which you will get in the description also. So go to OPT folder, we'll just give the path, then in wrappers, and the file is unl_wrapper, then -a fix permissions. This command we write to make all the permissions possible after we change the permissions. So hit enter, and as you can see, the command has been run. So now you can access the EVNG on your browser. So my mouse cursor is in the EVNG. To come out of it, just press Ctrl and Alt together, and the mouse cursor is in desktop now. Now we will go to the browser and access the EVNG by its IP. So as you can see, my EVNG has been opened. Now in web browser, the username is admin and the password is same, which is EVE. As you can see, my EVE has been opened. I will create a new lab by clicking here first option, which is add new lab. Then add any lab name, like I am giving ABC, then press the save. My lab has been opened, and you need to right click here, click on node, and type the name of the device which you added. Like I added 3700 series router, so here I will type 3, and you can see the highlighted option. Just click on it. Here you can select the number of nodes to add, like number of devices you need. So I need like 5 routers, and here you can change the symbol also. So let me change its symbol, and here you need to select the interfaces, or you can say slots of the router. So slot 1 is empty. I will select 1 fast Ethernet, which is 1 FE, and slot 2 is, again I am choosing 1 FE. So I'll just click save, and here you can see the all the 5 routers are now here. Similarly, if you want the 7200 series router, just right click, then node, then you need to type 72, and as you can see, 7206 series router is here. You can change the name also. I am just keeping it R, and I need 2 routers. The symbol I'll keep same. Slot 1 I will keep 4 Ethernet ports. After that, click on save, and both of the routers are here. To connect both of them, you need to keep in mind that both of the devices, or all of the devices, must be in shutdown state in order to connect them with wires. So all the devices are shut down right now, so you can now connect them. So as you can see, first I will hover on the router from which we need to create the connection, and here you can see the plug which you need to click and stretch to the other router here in the blue adapter, and here you can choose the interface from R6 and to R7, then click save, and here you can see the both of the devices are connected now. Now to turn on them, just right click on the router and click on start. Similarly, you can click on another router and press start. Now if you have a big lab and you have many nodes or devices, it will be difficult to start each and every device. So for that, EVNG has provided us a great function, which is here you can see more actions. Click on that, and you can start all the nodes at once. You need to refresh this web page. Now as you can see, all the routers have been started. Similarly, if you want to turn off them, go to more actions, then stop all nodes. Now you need to refresh again and you can see all the routers have been turned off. If you want to zoom, here is the zoom bar. You need to, if you want to increase the size, you can stretch it at the positive side, and if you want to see a larger view, just you can go to the negative side. You can also switch to dark mode here if you are a dark mode fan. So this was it for today, guys. Let me know if you faced any issue. You can comment down below and I will definitely reply. And I have provided all the download links in the description, just check it out. And don't forget to subscribe our channel. You will miss a lot more awesome tutorials if you don't subscribe. So just subscribe to this video, like this video, and I'll see you again in the next video. Till then, goodbye.